And then, you know, you're the carrier of that vision. So at the beginning, it's overly communicating over and over.
There's a lot more opportunity for them to develop skills in problem solving and collaborating among a group.
And so they need to have that monthly kind of check-in to say, okay, no, we're moving. Even if we're taking a baby step, we're still moving.
But it's good work because it impacts students. I would say the biggest hurdle when we were looking at implementing is time. Time to really design the lessons and to do it well.
Just with anything, it was a new initiative, and so change is hard for everybody. And so I think just the shifting from letting go of just teaching to the students and letting go of that, I don't want to say control, but just the way that they were used to teaching, and allowing the students to lead the work and be more autonomous with their work.
We had to talk a lot about the why. We did pretty well in test scores, and if that's the only thing we're gauged on, why are we doing this? We're already doing okay. But that's not the only thing that we are charged to do with our students. And so making sure that they are well-rounded and have the skills they need that will transfer to any area.
One of the things that I think we have to be very careful of as school districts is putting in too many initiatives all at once. And when the active learning framework was first introduced, I think the teacher's mindset was, oh no, here comes another initiative that has to be put into place that will be around for 1 or 2 years, and then everything's going to change and it's going to go away. However, as teachers went through the learning process of it, it doesn't become an initiative so much as a way of teaching. And I think when you shift away from the word initiative into a way to teach children, that whole concern dissipates.
I think kind of getting that momentum and figuring out what it meant for the campus. And so that's one of the reasons why this year we said we're all in. We're all doing it. And there's not going to be 3 years, there's not going to be 10. It's we're all doing it or we're not, right? I mean, so that was one of the big hurdles of saying, listen, you just got to go in. You got to go all in and get everybody together so you start talking the same language. You start having the same coaching sessions. Everybody's got coaching. I have coaching, the admin. I mean, so that's where you kind of need to make that as a buy-in.
When we look at the support very early on, one of the big things that we did is really look to develop a campus team. And in developing that campus team, we knew that these teachers were going to need support and the teachers were going to need help. But we also had to do vision casting. And we knew that it couldn't be around one person to support really the process of implementation.
What also helped me was the principal meetings and just sharing like our bright spots and our struggles.
I think that the support that happened early on was having a coach of my own, because my colleagues are going through it. We're all learning together. We can share ideas, learn from each other. Some of us have the same coach, E2L coach, and so that's been helpful.
The coaching has helped them feel more secure in what they're doing, along with opportunities to view other teachers, because sometimes in their own private world of the classroom, they're doing things that they do not recognize necessarily as part of the active learning framework, but it is. And so their coach is useful to validate that, because their coach will see it from the lens of the framework and their expertise.
What's good about having an outside coach to come in and do it as opposed to someone on campus or the administrator is that they're not evaluating them. You know, they're really just there to support them, to help them reflect on where they need to go to set goals.
I get a coaching session. I have pulled all my admin team into those coaching sessions, so they're being coached along with me, because I think that's one of the pieces that campuses miss, is that, you know, teachers need to be doing, you know, teachers need to be coached. I think also the administrators need to be coached as well. And it needs to be all the APs. You're trying to change a culture. So you're going to have the early adopters that are like, I love this, this is the best thing in the world. And then you're going to have some teachers that are, you know, kind of in the middle. And then you're going to have some very, you know, the skeptics. And the coaching has been allowed to help kind of the skeptics.
So as we made the shift from a teaching platform to a learning platform, we really worked a lot on culture. And so we really on this campus worked to really provide that growth mindset type of positive cultures where teachers were really focused on students.
It's been a lot of observing each other, observing myself as I attempt to use the structures during things like faculty meetings, for example, and for us to all wrap our heads around what did that look like? That was active learning.
And just something as simple as asking kids, you know, what are you learning instead of what are you doing? Then just letting them know that it's new for us too, and you know, it's scary for all of us, but we're all learning together. And I think that's important that the teachers know that as well. Active learning is new for me too.
So we've seen a lot of growth with students who are in classrooms with teachers who are implementing the ALC with fidelity. So in those classrooms, that's where we have our highest scores with regards to district assessments or campus assessments.
These are students that are actually owning their learning. And so early on, they're making decisions on, okay, this is what I know, this is where I'm at, and this is where I need to be. Here's a roadmap, and those are life-ready skills.
It was part of the reason we went from an improvement required campus to meeting all four state indices with 4 out of 6 distinctions. I can tell you there's a direct correlation between active engagement of students following the active learning framework and that end result.
There are going to be some difficult times. However, the outcome is worth it. The results that you see in the classrooms makes it all worth it. We went through a point where our teachers were about to throw the towel in, but the minute that I spoke to my coach and I said, here's where we are at, we're having these challenges, I need to go see this implemented somewhere where it's being effective. And so we went down the street to Crouch Elementary, and just taking a team of teachers and them seeing for themselves, it really inspired them. They got reignited and they were like, we're ready to do this work. We can't wait to do this work. And so that really turned it around for our campus.
Do not let the naysayers drag down your people who are willing to try and willing to step out there. And what you've got to do is accentuate your bright spots, not in a way that makes everybody else jealous or angry, but to say, hey, this can be done. This person is just like you. And not to set those people on a pedestal, but rather to invite the educators who are struggling into conversation with those folks, into the opportunity to view their classroom and watch the instruction and realize, hey, these kids are not different from the children I have in my classroom. This teacher is not different from me. He or she struggles in the same way, and yet they're making it happen.
Don't let the coaches be the coach. You be the coach in chief. You go into those classrooms. You acknowledge the hard work the teachers are doing. You are the one sitting with the students asking the questions that raise the level of interest. Because if you're showing interest, your teachers will show interest, your students will show interest. And I go into the classrooms and ask the kids the questions. Then they say, oh, this is really important. Mrs. Scott is in the classroom. She wants to know what we're doing.
Celebrate successes. Any little thing and all those little wins that you have, just celebrate them. Let's name them. Let's put them on a picture. Let's give them a certificate. Let's celebrate those successes. So that way they really see the impact. And that impact is going to translate into the excitement and the momentum on the campus. And then, you know, you're the carrier of that vision. So at the beginning, it's overly communicating over and over in that mission. But it's good work because it impacts students.